Tonight on Tom's Room of Schools Today, we will take a look at how some animals received a helping hand.
And as always, we have a look at some of the events from around the school district. Tom's River Schools Today starts in 2 minutes.
When your day is long and the night is yours alone, when you're sure you
Hello and welcome to Tom's River Schools Today for Tuesday, September the 22nd, 2015. I'm Leanna Lamasella.
And I'm Liz Necker. Tonight we see how SeaWorld lended a helping hand to some sick lions.
But at first tonight we take a look at our elementary school happenings in our elementary happening segment.
Starting off our elementary happenings, please bring your food for a donation to West Dover for Food Drive Friday. Your help can go a long way.
At the home of the Huskies at Hooper Ave, come out to PTO Fun Day scheduled at the end of September. The day will be held on the 26th. Check with your teacher or the main office for more information.
Taking a look at Walnut Street Elementary, come out and pick up a good book at their book fair. The fair ends on the 25th.
Let's take a look at today's random fact of the day. I always look and then I'm still on the thing.
Hi, I'm Peter Ebony with TV21's Random Fact of the Day. Did you know the $5 bill is slightly heavier than every other denomination of paper in U.S. currency?
It's time to take a trip around the world in our 60-second road trip. Can you guess where we are today?
What?
You could travel the world, but nothing could.
Wild San Diego has released the last remaining sea lions sickened by a summer oil spill. Abby Gibb was there when they made their return to the wild on Friday.
This is the goal. This is the moment for us.
There are certain moments in everyone's life that you'll never forget.
Come on, dogs. It's time to go home.
Today was one of those for Jody Westberg. She and her 70-person crew over at SeaWorld rescue stranded animals every day.
Animals that couldn't even pick up their head when they stranded. You could see their ribs, their spine, their hips. And now all you see, as you guys notice, is a little bit of blubber waddling down the beach.
Today, one of her life's unforgettable moments came thanks to these seven little guys, three of which were victims of a man-made disaster. Just 4 months ago, oil covered the waters and beaches of Santa Barbara, killing more than 100 sea lions. The SeaWorld rescue team found 62 alive.
One, two, three.
And today, it was finally time to return the last of them to the water. It was kind of a media mess as we all tried to help corral them.
Don't come to me.
Finally, they were home.
He ate it in the wave. He looked more like me boogie boarding than a sea lion right now.
It's been tough for the rescue crews, who are used to saving about 200 sea lions a year. So far, they've helped 800 this year, including this female.
Call her 769.
With that tracker on her.
When she's stranded on the beach, she weighed 10 and a half kilos.
That's almost down to birth weight. Now, her tracking device will provide valuable information about why hundreds of sea lions are starving and needing these rescuers' help.
She had the attitude of a survivor, and to see her get through this and be back out there now and be a scientist at sea for us, this is what we've been working towards.
Towards unforgettable, important moments.
It's now time for us to take a look at the dictionary.com's word of the day. Today's word is enervate, meaning to deprive of force or strength, to destroy the vigor of, weaken. And now for today's sentence. They enervate themselves by sensual indulgences and consume spirits and spices by wholesale. Now we are going to take a short break, but coming up, we take a look at our intermediate happenings.
And we also take a look at your weather. So stick around, we'll be right back.
This is Jamie Deffert. You're on TV 21.
Welcome back. Starting off our intermediate happenings at Intermediate South, it is Seminole Spirit Day every Friday. Don't forget to wear your Seminole colors. Spirit wear is on sale in the school store.
All students are reminded if they would like to see any sporting event at Intermediate South, you must go home first, then return at game time with an adult.
It is now time for our environmental tip of the day. Each day we will bring a tip that will help save the environment. Let's take a look at today's tip.
I'm RT Terry with TV21's environmental tip of the day. Make it a full load. The average washing machine uses 40.9 gallons of water per load. If you buy a new washer, shop for a high-efficiency washer that needs less than 28 gallons of water per load. To achieve even greater savings, wash only full loads of laundry or be sure to choose the appropriate load size on the washing machine.
Every day on this show, we will be bringing you a tip of the day, so stay tuned, and tomorrow as we give you another way to help save the environment. I literally read this.
A man in Berkeley, California got an amazing deal from Domino's Pizza Friday. Along with the pizza, the delivery chain accidentally threw in $1,300 cash back. Natasha Zuves reports.
So I ordered some pizza. I thought I had the day off and I was going to sit home and just enjoy my relaxation.
This story starts with the ordinary. Mike Vegas of Berkeley called up Domino's and ate just one slice before putting the rest of the order in the fridge. It wasn't until several hours later he noticed.
My phone started blowing up. You know, I wasn't looking. It was random messages and I was at work, so I wasn't answering.
Those phone calls would be from the delivery driver who had been on his way to the bank with just one more delivery to make. He put the cash in the wings box for safekeeping, but made a big mistake.
And about 5 a.m. I got home from work and looked at my refrigerator and pulled out what I thought was wings and turned out to be $1,300.
We had $666 here and $632 here for about $1,300 total.
It's one of those moments you wonder, what would you do?
I made a Facebook post and of course there's a long list of people, you know, arguing, you should keep it, you shouldn't keep it, you should keep it, you shouldn't keep it. I wanted to keep it, believe me, but I can't do it.
We watched as he walked it in.
No, thank you so much. You know, honest people are really, really hard to find these days.
And it looks like karma might be a real thing after all.
So thank you. We're going to offer you free pizza for a whole year.
It's an offer Mike plans to take the chain up on.
I'm going to have to start working out more, obviously. So.
It's one of the most famous shopping streets in Asia. Singapore's Orchid Road is home to all of the big luxury brands, but also to an unusual natural phenomenon, one that gives new meaning to the expression urban jungle. CNN David Malko explains.
It's Saturday, and Singapore shoppers are out in full force. As the sun sets, the crowd builds, not on the ground, but in the treetops.
You see the birds, they are keep flying everywhere. They came from, you know, there's all together about 5,000 of them.
Yeah. How many?
5,000 of them.
Up here, the first thing that hits you is the noise. But down on the street, well, let's just say, look out below.
Wow, it's lucky.
It's lucky?
Yes.
In Chinese culture?
Yes, it's lucky.
The worst culprits are the Javan Minas, says Stephen Goh with the Orchard Road Business Association, and they've been coming every evening for at least a decade.
If these birds could understand you, what would you want to tell them?
Stay out now until midnight and come back, you know, where there's no visitor.
Businesses here have tried everything and anything to get these birds to try another spot. They even brought in a trained hawk from a local bird park. But apparently there are so many birds, even the hawk got spooked.
It's obvious what they're saying. This is my roost, get out of the way.
Wildlife consultant Subaraj Rajathurai says Orchard Road's bird problem is entirely man-made. The angsana trees were brought in decades back to quickly green the city. The minas came from Indonesia.
They work in gangs, so they're very successful. Secondly, they're commensals of man, which means they do well in an urban environment.
Subaraj says to convince the birds to move on, you first have to understand why they're here.
If you choose a tree that's got compound leaves, where it's open and light penetrates, birds don't like it.
Move these trees away, he says, and the birds will follow.
Away from people, away from houses, they can poop in the grass all they want.
Chances are, it's probably not a priority, because most people here don't appear to let the birds get between them and a bargain. David Molko, CNN, Singapore.
Wow, it is now time for another break. Coming up later in the show, we will take a look at our high school happenings.
Tom's River Schools Today will be right back.
I knew I needed help paying for college. I've always wanted to be a teacher. I used to make worksheets for my friends to do. No one ever wanted to come over. My guidance counselor told me about federal student aid, and my mom helped me fill out the free application. I got the grants and loans that made school possible. There is a way to pay for school. You just have to find it. My name is Caitlin. I'm going to be a special education teacher. I'm going to live my dream.
Starting off our high school happenings, attention students and staff. The school store is now open to serve you. We are stocked with all your Raider apparel needs, including Champion and Under Armour brands. The school store is open every day after school from 1:40 to 2 p.m. We also have Yoo-Hoo, Snapple, and water for $1, as well as many delicious snacks to get you energized for your after-school practices. Stop in soon. It's time to get Raiderized.
Attention seniors, is your college coming to visit? Please stop by the guidance office to see the list of college visits and when their representative will be coming to High School East. It's that time of the year again. High School East course clothing collection, unwanted clothes, purses, belts, stuffed animals, bed linens, bring them in a plastic bag to room CO5 by the morning of Wednesday, October the 21st.
Attention all of our wonderful East students. We are looking for leaders with problem-solving communication skills to work with our teachers and parents to improve school outcomes related to student attendance, behavior, and overall school climate. We're holding individual committee meetings at the end of this month and would love to have you involved. Are you interested? Check out the flyer in your teacher's classroom in the main office for further details.
Switching to High School North. Every Wednesday is Green Day here at North. Remember to wear green to help get the word out about the need for recycling and energy conservation. It is now time for us to take a short break. After the break, we will take a look at our 3-day weather forecast.
Tons of our schools today. We'll be right back.
But I've never touched nothing that my spirit could kill. You know, I've seen a lot of people walking around with tombstones in their eyes.
I only had 12.
Seems to be the problem, Ossifer.
Sir, have you been drinking tonight?
Starting off sports. The stock car racing community is mourning the loss of one of its own today. Longtime competitor Leon Gagnon died Saturday after winning the final race of NASCAR's Wheel and All-American Series in Fairhaven, Vermont. Alexandra Leslie has more.
On a breezy, sunny Sunday in Fairhaven, a cloud hangs over Devil's Bowl Speedway.
You know, in a situation like this, everybody's in shock.
63-year-old Leon Gagnon took his fifth victory lap of the season here Saturday night, a victory lap that would be his last.
And I heard the engine of his car accelerate, you know, very slightly. And then there was a loud bang.
Owner Mike Bruno watched Gagnon's last moments as he says he rounded the corner, had a stroke, and crashed into the speedway wall.
I've reached out to the family today, and anything that we can do, we will be there for them, and they know that. And you know, they're grieving right now. In this sport, it's all a big family. I mean, I had messages today from people all over New York State, Florida, people that he's touched up and down the East Coast.
Bruno held back tears, describing his longtime friendship with Gagneau, emotions he did not wish to show on camera.
I grew up watching him. Later on in life, I raced against him. He was a tough bird. Don't let his age kid you. He would call out the young guys. He'd point his finger at him if he felt that they did him wrong. A lot of people looked up to him.
Bruno says the 42-year racing veteran was known for being a tough competitor and always drove one-handed.
At his age, he could wheel it like a 16-year-old.
Leon Gagneau's family has respectfully asked us not to show where he spent his final moments here on the track, but behind me, you can see his number 4, displaying proudly here at Devil's Bowl. The symbol of a man with a big heart, a steady hand, and a legacy that will live on.
He died doing what he loved to do. For him to be able to carry the checkered flag, win the race, and then pass on doing what he loved, that's a storybook ending to a life right there.
Let's now take a look at our three-day forecast coming up tomorrow. The sun will be back with a high of 76 and low 58. For Thursday, it will be sunny with a high 77 and low of 61. And finally for Friday, it will be sunny with a high of 72 and low of 62.
Wrapping up tonight's show, the next story may be tough for some animal lovers to watch. The massive Valley and Butte fires in California have burned more than 144,000 acres so far. UC Davis's Veterinarian Hospital has stepped up to help some of the littlest wildfire victims. Kimberly McDougall has more.
Burned feet, singed whiskers, and a bad case of smoke inhalation. This little cat was rescued from the Valley Fire, but is now getting much-needed care at UC Davis Veterinary Medical Teaching Hospital.
We've received about 18 or 19 patients. Most of those are dogs and cats. We have a few livestock as well.
The Valley and Butte fires burned so fast it caused people to flee their homes with only a short time to prepare, sometimes without their four-legged friends. Recently, volunteers and UC Davis veterinary doctors have been able to go into the areas deemed safe and save some of the animals. Rescuers have found so many animals in need of care, local clinics are full, so a handful have been brought back to UC Davis for care.
Most of these patients are burn victims. Some of them are minor, but we do have a number of patients that have significant burns with secondary complications.
UC Davis has about a dozen cats, two pigs, a goat, and two horses they're caring for. One of the most serious cases is this female goat found wandering along the highway at the Valley Fire. She has burns on her face, tongue, neck, and side. She is so bad they've had to feed her a liquid diet and do breathing treatments every 4 hours.
Burn patients are always a real challenge. The initial burns are significant, but the secondary problems that can set in are sometimes the more significant issues.
So far, UC Davis has only been able to track down a couple of cats and two pigs' owners. It was an emotional reunion.
We have people that have been devastated by wildfires. Sometimes their houses have burned down, and to receive a pet back after you think it might have died in the fire is pretty special.
Remember, if you have a story you would like us to cover,
or if you have an announcement about an upcoming event, please send an interschool mail to the TV studio at High School East, or you can email us at tv21@trschools.com.
Also, be sure to tune in to TV21 throughout the day to catch this show as we bring you stories from around the district. Also, please take a look at our website, www.trschools.com/TV21.
Well, that wraps up tonight's show. From Tom's River Schools Today, I'm Liz Necker.
And I'm Leanna Lamasella. Have a great night.